This is an FDM 3D print that's just barely bigger than a grain of rice. And this is a beautiful Japanese-made 0.1mm nozzle that I used to print the part. These prints with this nozzle are so small that I often thought my print failed when entering my office, only to notice how small I was really able to go. How challenging is it to print with such a tiny nozzle on a regular 3D printer? What details can we achieve? And how does this all stack up to resin 3D printing? Let's find out more. Guten Tag everybody, I'm Stefan and welcome to CNC Kitchen. So recently, Key from Kaika sent me a message and asked me if I'd like to take a look at their 3D printing nozzles. I get a ton of these messages and usually decline them since reviewing yet another nozzle with a special coating or alloy isn't just that interesting for me anymore, and probably also not for you. The thing that excited me though was that these are Japanese made nozzles that you can get with an orifice diameter down to 0.1mm, which is thinner than anything I ever used. Compared to standard 0.4mm nozzle, this enables you to add way more fine details onto prints, though comes with challenges. 0.1mm nozzles aren't a novelty, but I visited Japan in 2019, which had a lasting impression on me. Japanese craftsmanship is something really outstanding, and the nozzles they sent me didn't disappoint in that regard. Instead of a plastic bag, the nozzles were shipped in a beautiful paper box with golden letters. The nozzles themselves were further protected in a micro test tube, which upon opening revealed the beautiful machined parts. Kaika have a bunch of different shapes for various printers and applications, though they come at hefty price tags of 6,000 yen for the small orifice nozzles, which is around $50. For the more standard 0.3 and 0.4mm nozzles, you pay 4,000 yen, which is $35. Seriously expensive, but just look how beautiful they are. The outer surfaces have a pristine finish. The 0.1mm orifice is perfectly drilled in the center, and different from other nozzles, the flat part on the nozzle tip has a reasonable size and is not too big to not smear out material that much. And yes, the 0.1mm bore is conventionally drilled and not ED machined or laser drilled. Drilling at such a scale requires a perfectly set up lathe, because even the tiniest run out would break the bits. I hope the nozzle gods won't hate me for that. But of course, I had to machine one open on my CNC router just to take a look at the internal finish as well, which I'm quite sure is significant at that scale. This one is the 0.15mm version, because I didn't have a smaller one to spare. The thing that's noticeable right away is that the tip angle of the drill they are using is even pointier than what we, for example, know from E3D nozzles. Though it seems that this also takes its toll on the surface finish, because I was able to spot some cheddar marks in the tapered section in comparison to the superb finish of the rest. I installed mine on a Hemera extruder that's mounted on my E3D tool changer. I chose this setup on purpose, because since we'll print quite a bit smaller than regular, the motion system for the axis should run smoothly, and a geared extruder allows the filament dosing precision that's necessary. Just that you get a sense of scale. For a regular 3D Benchy printed with a 0.4mm nozzle, we use around 4.5 meters of 1.75 mm filament that we extrude in the course of 1.5 hours. A quarter scale 3D Benchy printed with a tiny 0.1mm nozzle only uses 7 centimeters of filament, and a 10% Benchy only 6 millimeters that the extruder needs to dose finely. This needs to be so precise that you can barely see the gears moving during printing, and any gearing in the system helps to increase the accuracy of the system. I used Polymaker's Polymax PLA because Richard Horn, aka Richrap, recommended it to me. He did a bunch of similar tests a while back and was so kind to share his experiences. Using the right material for these tiny nozzles is quite important. If any particles are in or on the filament that are too big, the nozzle will clog. Then the material can't decompose too fast, Because we extrude so slowly, it takes around 10 minutes for the material to travel through the melt zone, whereas with regular prints, it only takes 10 seconds. If a polymer can't handle that, it will clog the orifice or significantly alter its properties. ABS, for example, has that tendency, and materials like PVA can crystallize and basically turn into sand. Maybe one of the even more important things is Polymaker's jam-free technology, where they, I assume, somehow anneal the filament on the spool to increase the softening temperature, which would otherwise be around 50 to 60 degrees Celsius for PLA. Plastics are a bad conductor of heat, but because the material is so slowly fed using these small nozzles, the heat will travel through the filament upwards, softening it and therefore potentially jamming the hot end. It's an assumption, but I didn't have a single case of heat creep during the almost 200 hours of test printing. When you extrude material the first time, it's crazy to see how thin the filament is that comes out of the nozzle, because with 0.1 millimeters, it's just as thick as a hair. I used glass as a printing surface because it's really flat, and then made sure that I got the first layer thickness spot on. Too close and the nozzle might be destroyed during contact with the glass, too far and the material won't stick. I first tried to use Prusa Slicer to create a printing profile, but later switched to Cura. Prusa Slicer seems to have some hard-coded settings that make support structures and roughs a pain to use at this scale. Cura gave me all the options and enabled me to create a profile without real issues. I set the nozzle diameter and then adjusted extrusion width and layer height accordingly. I printed all of the parts at 0.05 mm layer height, which is 50% of the nozzle diameter, and used an extrusion width of 0.11 mm. I reduced printing speeds to only 10 to 15 mm a second to tackle curling on overhangs, and printed my tiniest temperature tower so far. Because we print so slowly, the material stays in the melt zone for way longer than usual, so we can lower extrusion temperature significantly because the material will always be equally heated through. I went with 180 degrees Celsius for my PLA. I printed on a raft and used a bed adhesion spray so that I can lower the bed temperatures to only 30 degrees Celsius after the first layer. If the bed is too warm, it radiates heat to the part, preventing it from properly solidifying and therefore decreasing print quality. Part cooling was even more important because due to the tiny parts, the nozzle and heater block is always close to the part and heats up the print. Switching the part shroud and adding a silicone sock helped quite a bit. Due to the tiny nozzle, I was able to reduce retractions to a minimum on the Hemera, and 0.5 mm was way more than enough to prevent stringing. And that's basically the setup. Using this profile, I was able to print a ton of well-looking parts at that scale. I scaled most of them down to 25%, since many were designed to be printable with a 0.4 mm nozzle and would otherwise take ages to finish. Speaking of scale and resolution, of course, the reason why we want to print with a smaller nozzle is that we want to increase the details on our prints. Even though most current 3D printers with their belt-driven system and microstep motors have a positional resolution of 0.01 mm, they can't resolve details smaller than a nozzle size. You might have seen this when trying to print a small text. So decreasing the nozzle size will enable you to print thinner walls and add more details. Of course, layer height is also a factor, but that plays more a role at sloped surfaces and can theoretically be adjusted quite independent of the nozzle size, at least when decreasing thickness. Because we're not only scaling down layer heights and extrusion width, but also printing slower, print times will skyrocket. Printing just a small 3D banshee with a setup will take more than a day. This means that small nozzles are just really feasible if you want to print small parts. You might even have problems printing a model designed for a 0.4 mm nozzle because small ledges are now big unsupported overhangs. I was really excited when seeing what amount of details I was able to produce on these small parts. Layers are practically invisible and even small structures come out really well. I honestly expected way more printing problems, but I think due to the combination of printer, nozzle and material, I had no notable fails and only one clogged nozzle. Cleaning that clock wasn't even that hard with a combination of the tiny acupuncture needles delivered with a nozzle and some cold pulls that help clearing out particles that block the nozzle. I know I was lucky here because I used cheap 0.25mm nozzles in the past and had constant issues. Unfortunately, I couldn't tune my support settings that well, partly because even Cura seems to have its problems at these sizes and Polymax PLA is quite ductile and doesn't snap off that easily. I'm sure I could do a better job, but that would require more tuning. So the print results and details I was able to get with such a tiny nozzle were amazing. But of course, we have to address the big elephant in the room. Doesn't resin 3D printing make all of my efforts irrelevant? Because even with my more than 2 years old Eligo Mars, I can print small and even more detailed parts right out of the box. Current resin 3D printers have a pixel size of around 0.04mm, plus or minus a little, and can therefore resolve details almost 3 times smaller than even with a 0.1mm FDM nozzle, which shows on the parts. Even though print times on a single part are fairly equal because MSLA printers expose a layer at a time, printing an armada of tiny parts takes as long as just one. And I will totally agree that if you want to print miniatures and other highly detailed visual parts, resin printing has many benefits. Though, after printing the parts for this video, I again realized why I barely use my Eligo Mars. The smell of the even low odor resin, even using a small fume hood, the mess and the sticky residue, the necessary post-processing and curing is just nothing I really enjoy. I don't even want to start talking about the amount of waste I generated just for a handful of prints. What I want to say with this is that resin printing isn't something for everyone, and in my opinion, way more unpleasant than filament printing with PLA or PETG, though at small scale, definitely more challenging. Then there is material choice. Of course, there are different property resins, but what they are really made of sometimes seems quite like a black box to me. What final, especially long-term properties resin parts will have is, in my opinion, almost impossible to judge, and is the reason why I wouldn't want to use resin prints for critical mechanical parts. The usual thermoplastic polymers we use in filament printing are way better characterized, diverse in properties, and therefore more predictable. And then there are niche applications like multi-material or just multicolor printing, which is possible in FDM and also with small nozzles, but not with resins. In the end, you have to trade off the advantages and disadvantages of both technologies to find out what's best for your application. I'm definitely not recommending that everyone now buys one of these beautiful Japanese micro nozzles because using these can be really challenging. But if you have an application for high precision FDM 3D prints and are not on a budget, I'm quite sure that the chance of success is way higher with these than with a sub $1 AliExpress part. I used quite a sophisticated setup, but I'm sure that if you don't want to go all the way down to 0.1mm, you can get small nozzles on a cheap NO3 working as well for small and detailed parts. But what's your take on printing with smaller nozzles? And where have you used them in the past? Where do you see applications? Or wouldn't you even start messing around and directly go to resin printing? Please leave a comment down below. Thanks for watching, everyone. I hope you found this project interesting. If you want to support my work, consider becoming a patron or YouTube member and check out the other videos in my library. I hope to see you in the next one. Auf Wiedersehen and goodbye. Of 6,000.